Narendra Modi to deliver his inaugural address.
Governor of Telangana, Sri S.L.L. Narasimhan, Advisor to U.S. President, Ms. Ivanka Trump, Chief Minister of Telangana, Sri K. Chandrasekhar Rao, my cabinet colleagues, Sushma Ji, Nirmala Ji, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, we are happy to host the 2017 Global Entrepreneurship Summit in partnership with the government of the United States of America. The summit is being held in South Asia for the first time. It brings together leading investors, entrepreneurs, academicians, think tanks, and other stakeholders to propel the global entrepreneurship ecosystem. The event not only connects the Silicon Valley with Hyderabad, but also showcases the close ties between the United States of America and India. It underlines our shared commitment towards encouraging entrepreneurship and innovation. The topics picked for this year's summit include healthcare and life science, digital economy and financial technology, energy and infrastructure, and media and entertainment. These are all important issues relevant to the well-being and prosperity of mankind. The theme, Women First, Prosperity for All, makes this edition of GES stand out. In Indian mythology, woman is an incarnation of Shakti, the goddess of power. We believe women empowerment is vital to our development. Our history has references to women of remarkable talent and determination. Gargi, an ancient philosopher around the 7th century BC, challenged the male sage to a philosophical discourse, something unheard of in this time even. Our warrior queens like Rani Ahilyabai Holkar and Rani Lakshmibai fought bravely to defend their kingdoms. Our freedom struggle too is replete with such inspirational instances. Indian women continue to lead in different walks of life. Our space programs, including the Mars orbital mission, have had immense contribution from women scientists. Kalpana Chawla and Sunita Williams, both of Indian origin, have been part of U.S. space missions. 3 out of 4 oldest high courts in India are now headed by women judges. Our sportswomen have done the country proud. This very city of Hyderabad is home to Saina Nehwal, PV Sandhu, and Sania Mirza. We have brought laurels to India. In India, we have provided for not less than 1/3 of women representation in rural and urban local bodies, ensuring women's participation in grassroots level decision making. More than 60% of workers in our agriculture and allied sectors are women. Our milk cooperatives in Gujarat and the Sri Mahila Grudyog Lijjat Papad are examples of highly successful and globally acclaimed women-led cooperatives movements. Friends, here at the GES, more than 50% delegates are women. Over the next 2 days, you will meet many women who have dared to be different in their own box of life. They now inspire a new generation of women entrepreneurs. I hope the deliberations in the summit would focus on how women entrepreneurship can be further supported. Ladies and gentlemen, India has been incubator for innovations and entrepreneurship over the ages. The ancient Indian treatise, Charak Samhita, introduced the world to Ayurveda. Yoga is another ancient Indian innovation. The entire world now comes together to celebrate Yoga Day on 21st June every year. Many entrepreneurs are involved in promoting yoga, spirituality, and traditional Ayurvedic products. The digital world we live in today is based on the binary system. The invention of zero, the foundation of this binary system, happened with Aryabhatta's birth in India. Similarly, many nuances of modern-day economic policy, taxation system, and public finance policies are outlined in our ancient treatise Arthashastra by Kautilya. Ancient India's expertise in metallurgy and also well known. Our many ports and harbors and the world's oldest dockyard at Lothal bear evidence to vibrant trade linkages. The tales of Indian voyagers traveling to foreign lands reflect the entrepreneurship character and spirit of our forefathers. What are the core qualities that distinguish an entrepreneur? An entrepreneur uses knowledge and skills to fulfill a motive. Entrepreneurs see opportunity in adversity. They try to meet the felt needs by making process more convenient and comfortable for the end user. They are patient and determined. Swami Vivekananda had said, each work had to pass through three stages: ridicule, opposition, and then acceptance. Those who think ahead of that time are sure to be misunderstood. Most entrepreneurs would be familiar with this. The power to think differently and ahead of the time for the betterment of mankind is what sets entrepreneurs apart. I see that power in India's young generation today. I see 800 million potential entrepreneurs who can work towards making the world a better place. The number of smartphone users in India is projected to grow to over 500 million by 2018. This offers immense potential for the growth of any venture in terms of outreach and job creation. Our Startup India program is a comprehensive action plan to foster entrepreneurship and promote innovation. It aims to minimize the regulatory burden and provide support to startups. Over 1,200 redundant laws have been scrapped. 87 rules for foreign direct investment have been eased in 21 sectors, and several government processes have been taken online. Our government has taken several steps to improve the business environment. The jump in India's ranking in the World Bank's Ease of Doing Business report from 142 to 100 in 3 years is a result of this initiative. We have improved on indicators like dealing with construction permits, getting credit, protecting minority investors, paying taxes, enforcing contracts, and resolving insolvencies. The process is yet not complete. This is an area where we are not satisfied with 100th rank. We would strive towards 50th rank. We have launched the Mudra scheme to provide easy finance of up to 1 billion rupees to entrepreneurs. Since its launch in 2015, over 90 million loans worth 4.28 trillion rupees have been sanctioned. Of these, more than 70 million loans have been sanctioned to women entrepreneurs. My government had launched the Atal Innovation Mission. We are opening tinkering labs in more than 900 schools to promote a culture of innovation and entrepreneurship among children. Our Mentor India initiative engages leaders to guide and mentor students through these tinkering labs. In addition, 19 incubation centers have been created in various universities and research institutions. This will nurture innovative startup businesses to become scalable and sustainable. We have created Aadhaar, the world's largest biometric-based digital database. This currently covers over 1.15 billion people and digitally process over 40 million transactions daily. We now digitally provide monetary benefits of various government schemes to the beneficiaries through direct benefit transfer using Aadhaar. Almost 300 million bank accounts with deposit of over 685 billion rupees, more than $10 billion have been opened through the Jan Dhan Yojana. This brings previously unbanked section of the society into the formal financial system. Of these, 53% accounts are of women. We are steadily working towards the less cash economy and have launched a unified payment interface app called BHIM. In less than a year, this platform is processing almost 280,000 transactions daily, having almost completed our program to connect all villages with electricity. We have now launched the Saubhagya scheme. This will provide electricity connection to all families by December 2018. We have launched a program to provide high-speed broadband internet to all rural areas by March 2019. Under our clean energy program, in just 3 years, we have doubled the renewables capacity from 30,000 megawatts to about 60,000 megawatts. Solar energy generation has increased over 80% in the last year. We are working on developing a national gas grid. A comprehensive national energy policy is also in the pipeline. Our Swachh Bharat mission to improve sanitation and cleanliness, and the rural and urban housing missions underline our commitment towards dignity of life. Our infrastructure and connectivity programs like Sagarmala and Bharatmala offer entrepreneurs many business opportunities for investment. Our recent World Food India Initiative help us engage with entrepreneurs in the food processing industry and agriculture-based sectors. My government understands that an environment of transparent policies and a rule of law providing a level playing field are necessary for entrepreneurship to flourish. A historic overhaul of the taxation system has been recently undertaken, bringing in the goods and services tax across the country. Our insolvency and bankruptcy code, introduced in 2016, is a step towards ensuring timely resolution for trace ventures. We have recently improved this further, preventing willful defaulters from bidding for stressed assets. Tough measures have been adopted to tackle the parallel economy, check tax evasion, and control black money. Our efforts have been recognized by Moody's recent upgrade of India's government bond ratings. This upgrade comes after a gap of almost 14 years. India has improved from its rank from 54 in 2014 to 35 in 2016 on the World Bank Logistic Performance Index. This signifies the relative ease and efficiency with each product can be moved into and from a country. An investment-friendly environment needs to be stable from the macroeconomic perspective. We have succeeded in containing the fiscal and current account deficits and curbing inflation. Our foreign reserves have crossed $400 billion and we continue to attract large foreign capital flows. To my young entrepreneur friends from India, I would like to say each of you has something valuable to contribute towards creating a new India by 2022. You are vehicles of change and instruments of India's transformation. To my entrepreneur friends from across the globe, I would like to say, come, make in India, invest in India, for India and for the world. I invite each one of you to become a partner in India's growth story. And once again, I assure you of our wholehearted support. I'm informed that President Trump had declared November 27, 2017, as National Entrepreneurship Month. America has also observed National Entrepreneurs Day on November 21st. This summit will certainly resonate with those themes. Let me conclude by wishing you fruitful, engaging, and rewarding deliberations at this summit. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Honorable Prime Minister of India, for your inspirational address. Thank you.